Welcome back, everyone. My name is Joel Feld, and today we are going to discuss the topic of customizing your Mac, specifically to external hard drives and folders. Let's rock and roll. In one of my previous videos about talking about formatting your external drives, I had a comment from Andy M. He said, "Joel, can you do a video on how to change the icon on folders in more detail, please?" Yes. Yes, Andy, I can, and I will. This is one of those things that I quickly showed in the other previous video, which I'll link down below, but it essentially allowed you to customize different folders and different external hard drives with different pictures or images. And the reason being just because you can. Why wouldn't you? It's the ability to just personalize your computer and your external hard drive to you and who you are. So with that, let's go ahead and jump in and I'll show you what I mean. I have two external hard drives here. I'm just gonna go ahead and plug both of those into my computer. And if I right click and wanted to create a new folder, and this would say Joel's new folder. For my external hard drive with the photos, it's this little robot guy sticking up his thumb with a little laptop. The Time Machine changes by default to the Time Machine logo, and then this is the internal Mac HD, and then you have this folder blue icon that's pretty generic for all of your folders that you create. So let's go ahead and say I wanted to put polar bear. Ooh, the Coca-Cola cola bear. Let's open up a new tab here. So I'm gonna say Coca-Cola polar bear. Oops, didn't spell bear right. We're gonna do images. I have all these different choices. And I'm gonna scroll through. I may not find exactly what I'm looking for. Let's do this one. This one looks like a nice poster drawing, something like that. So I'm gonna take this and I'm just gonna drag it to the desktop, which I have a whole bunch of images on the desktop. So let's just open up the Finder and navigate to desktop. And here is that image here. Whenever you have a file selected, if you press the space bar, that gives you an option that's called Quick Look. It just quickly shows you that item without actually fully opening it up in a particular app. I use it 99% of the time and it's awesome. So here's that image of the Coca-Cola bear. Say Coca-Cola bear. And when I double click on this, it's gonna open up in the default app, which is Preview. Now let's just say I want to do it to this folder here. I wanna put this bear as the folder icon. So what I would do is I need to get the information on this folder. So if I right click on the folder and I choose Get Info, that's option number one. I could also click once on the folder to select it, go up to File and choose Get Info, or I can do the keyboard shortcut, which is Command I, which is located under the File menu, and you'll see that it is Command I for Info window here. Now when that happens, the information is just showing you information about whatever you have selected. But in the top left, you have this little folder icon. And notice when I click on it, it actually turns it blue. It highlighted it. So if I click off of it, the highlight goes away. If I click it again, it highlights it. So I can actually come over to the Coca-Cola bear. We're gonna go to Edit and choose Copy. And I'm gonna go to the folder here and we're just gonna choose Paste. And what that does is it now pastes that icon for that folder. Now you'll notice here though, it has a whole white background and it looks like clip art and I don't like it. This is where, to take it a step further, we can actually get rid of that whole background, which is very easy to do. And I can do that right here in Preview. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use the markup tool inside of Preview. And in the top left, there's a tool called Instant Alpha. When I click on this, it gives me the ability to have a tool that essentially says, take out this solid color, whatever it may be. So if I click and hold and start to drag, notice it's defining and getting rid of all of the white around that bear. Now, if I go too much, it's starting to go into the bear and I don't want that. So I need to back it off a little bit. And if I let go, it's now selected all of that. So if I press delete on the computer, it's gonna say, hey, do you wanna convert this JPEG, this document into PNG? I'm gonna say, yes, yes I do. And then it gets rid of all that. Now, I'm going to take it a step further because I could do the same thing with the rest of the white up here, but I'm just going to crop this photograph. So I'm going to take the selection tool and we're just going to select part of this, and we can use the little blue dots as ways to refine the selection. I'm going to go up to tools and we're going to say crop, and now we're just left with this bear. So now if I do edit, select all, we're going to do edit, then copy. Now I can come back to that folder here and I can either do the keyboard shortcut of Command V, or I could go up to edit and choose paste. But now that folder icon, notice it's now the bear itself instead of the whole picture with the white background. It just looks a lot better. So that's a way that you can customize that, and it just looks fun. So let's do another one here. Let's say I want to create a folder for each of my kids. Here I have a picture of Ariana, we have Bennett, we have Daniel, and we have Hudson here. Now, if you don't want to use the Instant Alpha tool, you can always do any kind of custom selection that you want. So let's open up Ariana here. We're going to go to Markup. I could use the Instant Alpha tool to get rid of this white background, but notice it goes too much, which is not going to work. So I can always use the selection tool and do a square if I wanted to, and I could edit, copy, and we could go to a new folder and we could title it the name Ariana. And again, I right click on this, I do get info, brings up the information tab, and then I can paste it right into that photo. And so now I have that as the image. Or I could spend some time, go back to preview, or I could do an elliptical lasso. If I hold down shift on the keyboard, it's going to do it in a perfect circle for me, which is nice. She really loves our dog. So we'll get him in there, and I'm gonna do copy, keyboard shortcut, we'll do paste. Instead of that box there, we now have a circle. So I could repeat the process and do it for all of the kids. I could pull up Hudson. I actually like the circle, it's actually not so bad. So we're gonna do go back to elliptical, and actually if I wanted to do the lasso and spend some time going here and just around his face, because this is where Hudson is gonna keep all of his documents in this nice folder, which honestly I would never do, I'm just doing it for the purpose of this video. We'll copy this, we're gonna create a new folder, we're gonna call it Hudson. We're gonna get the information, we're gonna come up here, we're gonna do Command V, and so now Hudson has his picture right there. So now all of these folders have that photograph. If we wanna go back to the internet and find a different photograph, we could pull up Stormtrooper, and maybe I want this as the image. But again, this takes me to Target. We'll just try dragging the photograph off to the desktop, but that didn't work. So let's try this one. Let's find out. We'll go to the Finder, desktop, and here is that photograph, but it is a WEPB file. So let's see if we can resave this. We're gonna go to Markup, because again, I don't want this white background on there. We're going to go to Instant Alpha and slowly go in, press delete on the keyboard. We're gonna duplicate it as a TIFF. And just for reference, TIFF files and PNG files allow you to have a transparent background, meaning that it's going to be crystal clear for when you save these images. So if I go up to File and do Export, you'll notice here that under all of these different formats, notice the alpha button. It allows you to have that alpha channel. So JPEG doesn't allow you to do that. It's always going to be there. But some of these other ones, like PDF, PNG, TIFF files, they allow you to have that transparency so that it doesn't look like clip art. I prefer PNGs. And we're going to do Stormtrooper. We could save it to the desktop. I'll click save. And here's that file. Now, I didn't really need to save that because all I need to do is go up to File. We're gonna, or go up to Edit, do Select All. We're gonna copy this. And then we can go back to, let's say, Hudson, get info, and select him in the top and do Paste. And then it would have that as the icon for that particular external hard drive or folder. And actually, I could change my Time Machine to that. So let's go Time Machine, we'll do Info. and select this, do Command V. And Time Machine is weird though. I have found that depending on the operating system that you're at, you can't change the icon. I haven't found the reason why or any documentation on it. That's just been my experience. So if you can't change the icon on your Time Machine backup, don't freak out. That's just the way the cookie crumbles. So here I'll type in my computer password, click OK, and now it's there. I can even take it a whole nother step further, and maybe I wanted to say markup. Oop, let's go back to markup. We're gonna add some text, and I'm gonna actually type in Time Machine backup. And I could select the text here, we'll bold it, italicize it, and now put that right smack on his forehead. We'll select all, copy, go back to this Time Machine folder, paste, and now it's gonna say Time Machine backup on the text, on that icon. It's kind of small, but you get the idea, you can still see it. So that's how you can take any of your own pictures and customize the folders, the external hard drives that you have. And also keep in mind, all of these images that you have here on the operating system, you can always get those as full size quality images also. So a lot of them that I, the one that I like to use a lot is the little automator guy. So I'll take this, do Command I, select this icon in the top left, and do Command C for copy. And then if I open up preview, and I'm not opening up a file per se, but if I go up to file, because I've already copied it, if I say new from clipboard, it's actually going to bring up that icon for me as an image. And then I can go up to file, I can go down to export, and then I can save it as PNG, and then I have that file saved. So that's kind of nice. You can take really any of these images that are on your computer from any software that you have, and that's a way that you can capture that image, which is really nice, and you can use it, alter it, edit it. Not that I recommend that, because that's probably copyright in some way, shape, or form, but that's how you do it. So Andy M, I hope that answered your question. I hope for others that saw this, you liked what you saw, you learned something. If you did, hit that little like button. If you want to support the channel, hit that subscribe button. I love making content for you guys, and it's little fun tricks like this that make it all worthwhile. So again, thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you next time.